Hey, what's up everybody? It's Lexi D here. If you are new here, make sure to subscribe. For those of you who are returning, welcome back. It is Veda day number 16. So I wanted to share with y'all in this video a little bit about what I do. My formal title is Technical Project Manager. I have been doing that for going on 7 years now. And really what that involves is managing my clients' expectations. Like that's the short version of it. And so I worked previously in an aerospace company, particularly in IT. I did that for the majority of my career, and now I have switched over to working in a software company where we sell software to customers, and then we have what's called a statement of work, an SOW for short. And then that SOW is given to me as a project manager to then execute against. And really what that means is our customer will buy our software and maybe they're new to our software, don't really know how to set it up. And so then we'll have the SOW that says everything that needs to be completed as a way to say all of their high level requirements of what they expect of how to get the software now into their system. And so my job as a project manager is to manage the client's expectations. That's the very short version of that. Really what that means is managing expectations around four key areas. One is going to be the scope. Scope is going to entail all of the requirements that are encompassed for the particular statement of work. Let's use the analogy of a house, right? If you're building a house, that is going to be a project. You have a list of requirements, things that you want for that home. So that would be your scope. The second thing is going to be budget, which is of course how much money you're going to pay for the home. In my case, it's how much money they are going to pay for the project to be completed to have the software deployed. The third item is going to be around the schedule. So how long it takes to actually build up your home. In my case, how long it takes to actually get the software ready for their end users to access it. And the fourth area is going to be quality, because quite frankly, it doesn't matter if your house has everything that you say it wants, that you want, within schedule, within budget, if it's of poor quality, right? If it's made up of sticks and stones, it's not going to be a home that lasts, and you want something that lasts. So very similarly in software projects, it's important to ensure quality. Quality will be things like ensuring as least bugs as possible, ensuring that the software is actually usable. There's various ways that you can measure quality depending on how you're looking at it. But overall, those are the four key areas that I look at in terms of managing my clients' expectations. There's a few others. I am a registered PMP, which means I have my project management professional certification. And so I definitely can delve into project management a lot more, but that's not what this video is about. It's not a course on project management. So yes, that's pretty much what I do, you guys. At a very high level, I manage the expectations of my customers. I ensure that they are happy, that they are satisfied, that they are aware of what's going on. To be honest with y'all, some people may just consider me overhead, meaning I'm not the person who actually does the work. I'm not the person who actually completes the configurations or sets up things. I'm the person who just ensures that it gets done, right? So I put together a schedule. I make sure all the requirements are collected. I make sure that we are tracking to a particular budget. And I also make sure, again, that there's quality, that there is good quality built into the project itself, so that when we get to the tail end of things, the client is ultimately happy, satisfied, and wanting to buy more of our software. So that's pretty much it, you guys. I want to thank you all for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Also, if you have any further questions, feel free to leave those below in the comments, and I'll be happy to share. Just didn't want to overwhelm y'all too much with information, because again, I have to remember, for me, I'm 7 years, about to be 7 years in the game of project management. So there's certain things that I say that I'm not even aware of that most everyday people wouldn't necessarily understand. So again, if you have any questions, definitely leave those below or send me an email, and I'll catch y'all in my next video for Veda day number 17. Deuces.